Now, after end of World War First, what was the situation in Europe? Number one, England was the most superior nation in Europe, or rather, I should say, in the world. That was considered a superpower. French were terrified by German power. Twice, German were able to penetrate in France. First, during Prince Bismarck, and second, under leadership of Kaiser William II in First World War. At that time, just imagine if Russia, as Russians, invaded Germany from eastern side, the aggression in France was affected. But otherwise, French were not able to defeat Germany alone. Say, Germany fought with Russia, France, England, and America, and obviously the betrayer Italy, simultaneously. Now, here, if only war was there between Germany and France, then obviously French power was not able to defend, attack, forget, but not even able to defend Germany. And therefore, French decided to construct a secured line between Germany and France. Keep in mind, twice enemy attacked from Belgium and then France. Enemy means Germany. They attacked first in Belgium and then they entered in France. But still, they constructed a secured line that is called as Maginot Line. They are from western border and not from border of Belgium and France. Now, in case of Italy, they were dissatisfied after the war. Only thing is that they were not lost the war. But what promises were made by Britain were not fulfilled. They were not getting any colonies in South Africa, in Africa particularly. They were not getting islands in the Mediterranean Sea. Particularly, they were interested in getting island over here that is called as Aegean Sea. They were demanding out certain territory from Austria. Only that was fulfilled. But many other demands of Italy were not satisfied. And therefore, there was dissatisfaction in Italy after the war. In case of Austria, they lost out their empire, Austro-Hungary Empire, they lost out. They lost out German-speaking territory, that is called as Sudetenland, to Czechoslovakia. And some new nations were produced over here. Now, this is very good concept. That there is small nation here. I'm showing here in green color. That is, say this map is not perfect, but I want to show here somewhere that Italy, Austria, and France, their border, a nation, small nation is there that is called as Switzerland. I hope you must all are aware. Where all three people, that means German people, that is Austrians, then Roman, that is Italian, and French are living together peacefully. Britain was having intention something like that nation should be there in eastern parts of Europe also. That was Czechoslovakia. This was made by combining Czech or Czech. The spelling starts with C. So many people are pronouncing Czech. I don't know what is the exact pronunciation, but Czech or Czech people. Then Slovak people, and to them Sudetenland from Austria, that is German speaking, they were tied together. Benes is the name of president of this Czechoslovakia, and the intention was that everybody here should be satisfied and he should serve as something buffer state or act as simply a very good center of peace when there should be there are crises like war. But nobody in this nation was satisfied. Sudeten Germans, they were considering themselves as German, but they were tied up to another part of nation which was not existing, and now it existed. Czech people should be dominating and Germans are recessive. So Germans were unhappy. Czech were not able to dominate the entire nation, so they were unhappy. Slovak were considering Czech as superior one. They were unhappy. Everywhere there was problem. We are saying these problems are of minority problems. But that's why Czechoslovakia was not peaceful nation in those days. Some disturbance was always there. And now we are talking of Germany. Germany was terrified by First World War. Again and again it was hammered that only Germany is responsible for World War. So when somebody is losing out war, then no options are there. Whatever the winners are saying, we have to accept that. Like in case of India, English people were again and again hammering on India that before arrival of Britishers in India, Indians were terribly backward. And now also they are backward, but we made them somewhat advanced till date. The loser Indian will always accept this. Those who are of superior mind, they will say, no, this is not the fact. Before arrival of Britishers, India was at its zenith. Best example, if you want to check out in architecture part, then the Taj Mahal is the world famous sign. If you visited Maharashtra, various caves are there, rock cut caves, rock cut temples. So that was there. Even paintings, if you visited Ajanta and Ellora, then in Ajanta caves there are particular paintings that survived till date. 1,000 years ago these paintings were carried out. If you visited Delhi, you'll get Vishnu Stambha, that is iron pillar or steel pillar. Still, it is not rusted. It is there in open ground. And for many centuries, it is as it is there. Even that is having very low expansion coefficient. Means on heating, it is not expanding to great extent, and on cooling, it is not cooling out to great, not contracting to great extent. That is, we can say linear expansivity of that is very, very less. And search out the miracles in India. Before arrival of Britishers, many things we were in advance in technology, in science, in astronomy, everywhere. But Britishers created this image that you were backward. Untouchability problem was there with you. You were not treating human as human. Yes, fact. I am not denying that untouchability problem was not there in India. But in those days, if you check out, the similar problems were there in Europe and Asia and other parts of world, particularly America. Check out what black and white problem is there, the racial problem, where white person, where I am not saying not today, but in those days, were treating black person in terms of equality? Answer is no. The way these white people in those days were treating out black people in those days is not at all justifiable. So if you are there standing in mud, then why you are telling other people that you are also in mud? Getting my idea? So Indians were already in mud. The untouchability problem was there. But that means not that Britishers were superior. They were also following this racial concept, racism, to great extent. In India also, in 20th century, they passed out Ilbert Bill. That is their greatness, no doubt. I have to accept that. They said that a European and Indian, two are there, then Indian judge can try out both. earlier law was that if one European is there and one Indian, then they must be tried by European judge only, not by Indian judge. Two Indians are there, then they can be tried by Indian judge. But two Indians, they can be tried by European judge also. Two Europeans, only European judge. Okay, Ilbert Bill says that if Indian, one Indian and one European, then he can be tried by Indian judge also. But this bill was terribly opposed by Britishers who were staying in India. And then the bill was withdrawn, taken back. So this way, the racial problems were there in the world in those days, and Britishers were not an exception for this type of rule. Now, Germans were loser of the war, and that's why they were called as 100% responsible for World War First. Now, actually, after accepting the plan given by Woodrow Wilson, German people were having assumption that this is the end of war. But later they realized that no, this is not end of war. We have to accept treaty. That is Treaty of Versailles. That was carried out in Paris, a suburb of Paris. And very humiliating terms were there in that. Germany accepted, but that was very, very insulting for Germany to accept these all terms. And therefore, we are saying that seeds of Second World War, they are there in First World War only, particularly in the Treaty of Versailles. That is the best example that how treaty should not be there. That is the best example. Anyway, now here, the world was just observing what is there with Russia. In 1917, Russia withdrawn from the war, and with Bolshevik revolution, Russia was having communist power there under leadership of Vladimir Ilya Ulyanovich, alias Vladimir Lenin. And then he decided to spread out communism all over the world. He encouraged communist activities all over the world. The communist parties were established in many nations. If they were already there, then these parties were strengthened out, and not there, then newly established. Russia was a tremendous undeveloped nation when there was First World War. No doubt, military was superior in old days. But after a certain period, others developed to greater extent where Russia was not. And now, the more advancement was carried out by Lenin in Russia with help of communism. For first 6 years, he spread out communism in Russia. He spread out communist activities in Russia. And then, after establishing that, to the surprise, suddenly he was shot by a female in his nation. One lady shot out him. One bullet was there in his neck and one was there in chest. The bullet from chest was removed, but bullet from neck was not removed. For next 6 months, he was almost paralyzed, and he was taking complete bed rest. And then suddenly one day he died out. Miracles. We don't know exactly what happened, because his wife says, that is named as Krupskaya, she says that Lenin was recovering from this attack, and suddenly one day he found dead. We don't know exactly what happened. But it is supposed that his disciple, Stalin, original name Joseph Zugashvili, ही वॉज फ्रॉम जॉर्जिया, जॉर्जिया इज हियर समवेयर, ही वॉज फ्रॉम जॉर्जिया. सो जोसेफ जुगाश्विली और जोसेफ स्टालिन, ही वॉज देयर ऑन थ्रोन, ही वॉज देयर इन पावर, इनिशियली टेम्पररी पावर, एंड आफ्टर डेथ ऑफ लेनिन ही अज्यूम्ड 100% पावर ऑफ रशिया. हिज मेन कॉम्पिटिटर ट्रॉटस्की वॉज डिपोर्टेड फ्रॉम रशिया एंड लेटर ऑन किल्ड इन इंग्लैंड. एनीवे नाउ ही डेवलप्ड बियॉन्ड उरल माउंटेन रेंजेस 90 न्यू सिटीज एंड ही मेड रशियन आर्मी टू ग्रेट एडवांसनेस. दैट ऑल ही कैरिड आउट वेरी वेरी ब्रूटल मैनर, बट ही ट्राइड टू स्प्रेड कम्युनिज्म इन ऑल अदर नेशंस, पर्टिकुलरली जर्मनी, पोलैंड, जेकोस्लोवाकिया, एवरीवेयर. द वर्ल्ड वॉज डिवाइडेड इन टू टू टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिकल पावर, वन इज कम्युनिस्ट पावर, सेकंड इज कैपिटलिस्ट. वेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इन डिटेल. राइट नाउ वी कैन कीप इन माइंड दैट इंग्लैंड, अमेरिका, फ्रांस, दीज नेशंस आर कैपिटलिस्ट नेशन, वेर एज रशिया, चाइना, इन दोज डेज चाइना वॉज नॉट ओनली रशिया, दैट इज कम्युनिस्ट नेशन. कम्युनिस्ट एंड कैपिटलिस्ट वेर अपोजिंग ईच अदर, बट स्टिल एज डेमोक्रेसी वॉज देयर इन इटाली, इट वॉज देयर इन इंग्लैंड, इट वॉज देयर इन फ्रांस, कम्युनिस्ट पार्टीज डेवलप देयर टू. इटाली वॉज हैविंग नॉमिनल डेमोक्रेसी अंडर लीडरशिप ऑफ किंग, पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज वेर देयर, बट नन ऑफ द पॉलिटिकल पार्टी वॉज एबल टू रूल फॉर मोर दैन 6 months. And at that time, a great person in Italy named as Benito Mussolini, he united people under name of his party that is called as Fascist Party. He united the people. He showed them the dream of Roman Empire again. And because of that, he got tremendous support from public. He promised that if he got power, then he should give Italians as colonies in Africa. He should give islands in Aegean Sea. And he will demolish or he will reduce the unemployment in Italy. Like that, various promises were given by Mussolini. Ultimately, he was opposing to communist activities. Communists become dominating in Italy. And so, with support of certain industrialists, he managed a march over Palace of King of Italy at Milan, a suburb of Rome, where he got power in his hand. This way, King appointed him a chancellor to development of Italy. Mussolini carried out certain efforts. Apart from fascist party, all other parties were considered as illegal. Newspaper were strictly under control of Mussolini. And like that, various freedom activity or democratic activities were banned, and ultimately the power of emperors also curtailed down. And this way, Roman power was concentrated in hands of Mussolini. After getting this type of power from Turkey, he obtained certain islands on rent or lease. But he fulfilled out what he promised. He carried out war here in Africa. A small nation is there that is called as Ethiopia, or in those days it was called as Abyssinia. He fetched war with Abyssinia. Abyssinian people were fighting, but ultimately Mussolini used chemical weapons, particularly poison bombs, on Addis Ababa, that is the capital of Ethiopia or Abyssinia. The Addis Ababa was badly destroyed by Mussolini. and ultimately Ethiopia surrendered out. So second promise was fulfilled, that getting colonies in Africa. Then about the militarization and all these activities, Mussolini able to manage out unemployment in Italy and continued to rule over Italy till Second World War. Now, after First World War, the impact was very, very bad. In order to avoid such incident, an organization here, that organization was set out, that is called as League of Nations. That was established. But League of Nations was not having any military power. And that's why League of Nations was not able to do anything with attack of Mussolini over Addis Ababa or Ethiopia, where League of Nations only protested out and ultimately nothing can happen. Then Japan here attacked on China. That territory is called as Manchuria. League of Nations was not able to carry out any activity over there. This way we got failure. We means League of Nations was having failure in controlling out the world situation. Now, in Spain, similar crisis was started out, that there should be democratic government or dictatorship government. So like that, world was facing another problem, that is rise of dictatorship nations. Like Italy was there, Russia was communist, but politically it is dictatorship. Economically it is communist ruler. So this way they spread out the dictatorship here. Now Poland was no doubt having the democratic their way, but still they occupied certain territories from Russia, which was actually initially part of Poland, but after war it was not. But still they fetched war with Russia and taken their territory from Russia back. So after World War First, it was not situation that now boundaries are fixed, and continuously war incidents were going on all over the world, like that originally obviously from Europe. Now Mussolini carried out attack here. This is a small Muslim nation in Balkan territory, that is called as Albania. So Italy or Mussolini carried out attack on Albania and managed victory over Albania. In case of India, after First World War, we got certain reforms, but no much political power was handed in hands of Indian people. Now the situation was this way, that world after World War was having various problems, political issues, as well as rise of communism. And to worsen the situation, there was a problem that is called as Great Depression in the world, that followed this incident somewhere in 1929. World War was ended in 18, but this incident was there in 29. Slowly and steadily, economy declined, and ultimately that was the world's major problem, that Great Depression was occurred over there. This is particularly situation of world after First World War. And now we are going to discuss Second World War, but before that I had to focus on Germany again, particularly with respect to Hitler's development in Germany. So in next lecture we are discussing about Hitler's development in Germany.